I was so hard-headed at first. My grandma didn't even believe in me. I kept going, though. All I can say is I told you. Jury at the bank now in the vault. You should have never doubted me. I'ma work to my last breath. I'ma hustle to my last breath. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you should have never doubted me. The pain and the struggle followed me. My daddy never that bothered me. And these cold streets made a man of me. Knew a time it'll come, they doubt me. Had to keep them OGs around me. Keep a young, young homie grounded. You never know where your motivation to come from. We do the most with these bras and pop sundown. They try to push you aside, you gotta fight some. I had a line on the thigh, and then we buy guns. I want that number one spot, I'm like icon. I got that beast in my eyes, I'm like.
I'm Mark, the Bumblebee DeLarosa. I'm undefeated as a professional fighter. I'm 21 years old. I've been training for about 7 years. My style of fighting is real technical and very explosive.
My name is Tony Cabello. I've been with Reyes Boxing for a little bit over 10 years. Been around boxing almost my whole entire life. I'm a boxing fanatic. Found Mark at 13 years old when he came through the doors. His IQ level was real high in the sport. He really outworked a lot of young kids. He outworked a lot of older guys too at the same time. Mark's always been dedicated to the sport, disciplined and controlling and working on his body and clean himself up inside, you know, inside the ring, inside the cage, outside. He lives a good life, you know, and it pays off. It pays off through his work ethic. We've done a lot, you know. I've instilled a lot of time, hours, you know, into bringing him up and bringing him up the right way and having him not just box, but be a good guy and lead by example for others.
Hello, my name is Steven, the Warman Wright. I'm the striking coach here at Team Takedown. I've been working with Mark DeLarosa since he was an amateur. You know, I wasn't cornering him at the time, but basically right when he had first started coming around the gym, we had some guys that were a little bit closer to his size. He's lost a lot of weight since I've known him. You know, when I first got here, he wasn't like, you know, crazy big, but he's probably in the 160s. Now he stays closer to his fight weight, which will be 125 pounds. But this fight is at 132, so the cut's not as bad, but he usually does a good job of, you know, watching his diet and so on in the off season. It doesn't get much bigger than 150 pounds. Mark DeLarosa's got, like, I would say he has the best work ethic of the guys that I work with, as far as the person who asks for the most time, asks for the most mitts. There was a day where I was holding mitts for him and I lost track of time and looked and it was 30 minutes and that was with no breaks. 30 minutes at a high pace and he just kept going, he just kept pushing. And I had to throw more kicks in to try to slow him down, but he just kept pushing no matter what. So, you know, whenever I'm working with Mark DeLarosa, I know that I gotta be in shape too, because this kid's just got the craziest motor. You know, it's funny because I've got to watch him grow, you know, as a young man, because he does a good job, you know, with his girlfriend and his adopted daughter Zaylin, and he's like working with his students at the gym at Genesis, and the work that he does in here, he's always willing to do extra, always willing to, you know, be a body, be a partner for whoever. DeLarosa is the perfect guy to have in the gym. He's the perfect guy to have, you know, as a fighter, because you know he's going to go out there and bring it every single time. And you know in the gym he's going to be there for everybody. He's just an exceptional person, exceptional athlete, and it's been a joy working with him.
My name is Kenny Monday. I'm the head wrestling coach for Team Takedown. I've been coaching here for a year. I took the job last August. It's been just an incredible year working with the guys. Been working with Mark DeLarosa for, you know, about a year since I got here. You know, Mark's just he's one of the hardest working guys that I have on the team. I've seen so much growth out of Mark in just a year. I mean, he's tough. His shape is incredible. Doesn't get tired. And just loves the sport. You know, he loves the sport. He comes to practice every day with a good attitude, and willing to learn. You know, he's one of the most coachable guys that we have here for Team Takedown.
In the ring, the first like 30 seconds, I like to get a good feel out process. I see how he walks. I start picking up his habits. I like to get a feel where he's throwing the most heat from, where if he likes switching stances, where he's throwing hard from. I start picking apart my jab. I start mixing up low kicks. At any point, I don't care who it is. At any point, if I get my hands on you, you're going down. If I want the takedown, the takedown's always there. But I always like showcasing my boxing and my striking. So I love picking people apart, standing up. So I try to pick up his bad habits. I try to pick up bad habits they do. If they, whether it's feints or whatever, I pick up bad habits and I capitalize on them. Make them pay.
There we go.
I compare my work ethic to Floyd. To be the best, you got to study the best. I work hard. I put in the hours. I put in a lot of training, 6 to 8 hours of hard training. I do this full time. It's not part time. It's not a hobby. This is my life. I don't compare it to a job. This is my life. All I do is eat, sleep, wake up fighting.
I believe that we've got the best athlete. I've got the better fighter. I believe that he can win the fight wherever it goes, whether it's in the grappling, boxing, kickboxing. I believe I've got the better fighter. We're going to come out. We're going to be aggressive. We're excited about the matchup. We're grateful for Sandoval and his team for taking the fight. And come December 5th, you're going to see the meanest Bumblebee you've ever seen. This kid is just going to bring the fight from the opening bell, and should be all excitement.
He's gonna win a world title. It's not, you know, it's just a matter of time. I can't tell you when, but it's just a matter of time. His time is coming.